In this video, I will explain in detail how the derivative of sine x becomes cosine x using the limit definition of the derivative, also known as the first principle. We'll use this formula to demonstrate how the derivative of sine x equals cosine x. Let's begin, shall we? First, let's write down the proposition we need to prove sine x prime is cosine x. Using the limit definition of the derivative of f of x is defined as the limit of f of x plus h minus f of x over h as h approaches 0. We'll define f of x as the function we want to differentiate sine x. Therefore, f of x plus h becomes sine of x plus h. To expand sine x plus h, we need to use the compound angle formula for sine. Let's take a moment to review the compound angle formula for sine. When you expand sine x plus y, we get sine x times cosine y plus cosine x times sine y. This means that sine x plus h can be expanded as sine x times cosine h plus cosine x times sine h. Now let's substitute the expressions for f of x and f of x plus h into the derivative formula. F prime x is limit as h approaches 0 of f of x plus h minus f of x over h. When we do this, the numerator becomes sine x times cosine h plus cosine x times sine h minus sine x, and the denominator is h. Let's rearrange the terms in the numerator. The expression becomes the limit of sine x times cosine h minus sine x plus cosine x times sine h over h. The first two terms in the numerator have sine x as a common factor, so we can factorize it. This gives us the limit of sine x times cosine h minus 1 plus cosine x times sine h all over h. Now, let's separate this fraction into two fractions, the limit of sine x times cosine h minus 1 over h plus cosine x times sine h over h. In the limit, as h approaches 0, the variable that is relevant is h within the parentheses. The terms sine x and cosine x are independent of h, so we can bring them outside the limit. This gives us sine x times the limit of cosine h minus 1 over h plus cosine x times the limit of sine h over h. If we simplify the expression, we can find the derivative of sine x by determining the values of the two limits inside the yellow boxes. The limit of sine h over h as h approaches 0 is equal to 1. In a separate video, I have provided a detailed proof of why this value is 1, and you can click on the link in the top right corner to view the content. Now, let's find out the value of the limit of cosine h minus 1 all over h as h approaches 0 for the first yellow box. To find the value of this limit, let's multiply the numerator and denominator by cosine h plus 1. The numerator becomes cosine squared h minus 1, and the denominator becomes h times cosine h plus 1. By using the trigonometric identity, sine squared h plus cosine squared h is 1. If we rearrange the terms sine squared h and the rightmost 1, we get cosine squared h minus 1 is negative sine squared h. Substituting this result into the numerator, the limit becomes negative sine squared h over h times cosine h plus 1 as h approaches 0. Now, let's separate the numerator sine squared h into sine h times sine h. The numerator of the limit becomes negative sine h times sine h. We can move the negative sign in front of the limit and express it as a product of two fractions, sine h over h and sine h over cosine h plus 1. As we have previously determined, the limit of sine h over h as h approaches 0 is 1. Therefore, the expression simplifies to negative limit of sine h over cosine h plus 1. As h approaches 0, the numerator sine h approaches 0, and the denominator cosine h approaches 1. Ultimately, the expression becomes negative 0 over 1 plus 1, which simplifies to 0. Hence, the limit converges to 0. Let's summarize the result we have found. We investigated two limits, And when h becomes sufficiently small, we found that the first limit of sine h over h becomes 1, and the limit of 1 minus cosine h over h becomes 0. Previously, we expressed f of x prime in this form, and by substituting the two limit values we found into the yellow box, sine x times 0 plus cosine x times 1, we are left with cosine x alone. In other words, we have proven that the derivative of sine x is cosine x. In the previous video, we proved why the limit of sine h over h becomes 1, and using that result in this video, we demonstrated why the derivative of sine x becomes cosine x. If you want to learn more about the differentiation of trigonometric functions through various examples, you can refer to the trigonometric functions differentiation video on my channel. How did you find today's video? If it was helpful, please like and subscribe. Thanks for watching. This has been your math guardian, Alex.